Mia James barely recognized her two-year-old grandson as he lay hooked up to machines in bed at Lurie Children's Hospital earlier this month. He was bloated from the fluids and he had tubes coming out of everywhere and he was on life support, said James. 45. I held his little hand. I kissed his little hands. And that was pretty much all we could do. Khalil's body had been airlifted from DeKalb, 65 miles west of Chicago, after suffering severe brain trauma. The little boy, described by James as a very happy baby, very loving, died 5 days later, on November 15, his father's 21-year-old girlfriend, Alexandra Hoyle, initially said the boy was hurt when a dog knocked him over. Court records show, but she later admitted to detectives that she slammed Khalil's head on the hardwood floor because he was not chewing up his food, records show. James, Khalil's maternal grandmother, said she and her husband often chipped in to help their daughter look after Khalil and his twin brother, DJ. She said she never had problems getting Khalil to eat and couldn't understand how he could have provoked someone. Khalil was the less fussy twin, she said. Khalil loved to eat, and that's why I really don't understand. James said, when he was done, he was done. There was no reason to force him to do anything. Just a month before Khalil's death, the Department of Children and Family Services had closed an investigation into the boy's biological parents after finding no evidence to support allegations that the twins were being neglected, according to the agency. The lady came over to interview and she saw the boys in the high chair eating, being fed and watching cartoons, said the boy's father, Dion Boddy. Hoyle was not investigated during the probe, according to DCFS. She was living at the home and caring for Khalil at the time, but was out of town when an investigator visited. Officials say she had not been implicated in the neglect allegations, which stemmed from a custody fight between the parents. Both parents had been taking turns looking after the boys. DCFS had also investigated Khalil's parents in May 2016. Investigators found credible evidence of neglect against the mother, but allegations against the father were unfounded, an agency spokeswoman said. Boddy said he had begun dating Hoyle in January and did not see any warning signs, big little brother James said. The boys spend many days at her home, watching Alabama football games in tiny jerseys and donning fedoras with their grandfather, or visiting the local pumpkin patch together. The twins had turned two on October 26. James had just taught them to throw their hands in the air and yell, touchdown. Khalil was vibrant and he light up the room just by walking in, James said in a phone interview. If you were anything but happy, all you had to do was hold him and he would look at you and touch your face. He loved to cuddle, and he was just a very happy baby, very loving. Khalil was the younger twin, but physically larger than his brother, James said. So, the family nicknamed him the big little brother. The boy's father described Khalil as very funny, active, happy and very adventurous. Khalil and DJ were inseparable, like Batman and Robin. Boddy said, on a GoFundMe page set up for Khalil's funeral expenses, the little boy is seen grinning widely with his short, curly brown hair peeking out of a beige fedora slanted on his head. He is standing in front of a large elephant toy with a tube for a trunk and wearing a shirt that proclaims, what happens at grandma's stays at grandma's. During hot summer days, the boys loved running around their grandparents' house in nothing but diapers and, for some reason, taking off just one sock, James said. They had recently started talking to each other in indecipherable twin babble. Sometimes, Khalil would put his chunky little hand on DJ, the more dramatic baby, to calm him down if he threw a fit, James said. As a newborn, Khalil spent more than 3 months in the hospital, enduring multiple surgeries and blood transfusions and having a shunt implanted in his brain, James said. So she grew concerned November 10th when she got a call that Khalil was being airlifted to Chicago from Northwestern Medicine, Kishwaukee Hospital. The DeKalb hospital told police the boy suffered a severe brain injury under suspicious circumstances. The next day, police arrested Hoyle Hidlery on a charge of aggravated battery of a child. After her interview with detectives, according to police and court documents, the boy's father told police that Hoyle was caring for the kids when Khalil was hurt about 1 p.m. Court records show Hoyle's bond was set at $500,000 during a hearing in DeKalb Circuit Court on November 11, but it was later reduced to $100,000, and her father helped post the money to get Hoyle out of the DeKalb County Jail. One of the conditions of her release was that she was banned from having contact with children younger than 18. Khalil died at Lurie at 3:31 p.m. November 15, according to the Cook County Medical Examiner's Office. His death was ruled a homicide due to blunt force head trauma and child abuse. Police then issued a warrant for Hoyle on 2 first-degree murder charges. Police said she was arrested and her bond was set at $5 million at her first appearance. Records show her bond was reduced to $750,000 on November 16 at Cherney at ChicagoTribune.com.